Well, hello everyone. As you can see, we're back at it again today. And today we're going to be working on making a Cascade Cycle heat exchanger. So, a while ago I tried to make this Cascade Cycle air conditioner. Didn't work real well. I think the majority of the problem was with the heat exchanger. So we're going to try to make our own little custom design heat exchanger today. Now, as you can see, I have with me here a brazed plate heat exchanger, but these are a little bit unsuitable for Cascade Cycles. And the reason why, let's pretend, say, we've got hot refrigerant coming in here, like straight out of the compressor's discharge, and it gets cooled and it comes out here. And so normally you would have cold refrigerant coming in here and coming out here on this side. But the problem is, this side's going to be red hot, this side's going to be ice cold. That's going to put a thermal gradient across this heat exchanger. That's going to put it under a lot of stress. So I had an idea, and this is what it is. We got a tube like this, and we got a coil like this. So we just put this inside there, and it's a tube within a tube heat exchanger, right? But my idea was to have two of these. So we get, and this is 1/8 inch tubing, by the way, we get two 1/8 inch tubes, and then kind of coil them up together. So we won't have a counterflow or a parallel flow heat exchanger, it'll be a dual flow heat exchanger. So Father's come up with a pretty good idea, again as usual, and he says we should take two strands of the 1/8 inch tubing and solder them together first before we wind them. He says solder them together first and then wind them, so we're going to try that, and that's what we're going to do today. We're just using the Stay-Brite 8 solder, and he's got the air acetylene torch. And we're going to try it out. Looks like he's tried a little bit already. We're going to try some more. Alright guys, I think you can see a little bit better what I'm talking about now. This is the finished product. And as you can see, we've got it all soldered up. And again, that's just coiled up 1/8 inch copper tubing, and there's two tubes actually co-coiled together. So again, the idea is simple. We're going to stick this inside that. So out of the two ends, here and there, these are going to stick out. I'm going to drill a hole through this cap so these two ends can come out and this inside will stay sealed. And the refrigerant from the lower temperature cycle will flow through there. So we'll have discharge from the low temperature cycle compressor coming in here, and it'll go out there. And then crossways, we'll have discharge coming in this one as well, and coming out this one. So, yeah, I understand that might actually make the liquid coming out of it a little bit hotter, but like I said, we're just going to try it. Not guaranteed to work. Just another one of my goofy experiments. So, and then these guys, these T's here, this will be for the higher temperature cycle. This will be the high temperature cycle's evaporator. So a cold refrigerant's gonna come in here, it's going to evaporate and go out there as a gas and back to the high temperature cycle. Right, so I'm just working on this end cap here, getting the holes in it. See if that fits. Nearly. All right, that's good. All right. All right, guys, so this is what it's going to look like. And pretty much fully assembled in this state, so just need to clean it and braze it. So as you can see, guys, I got it all cleaned up, all put together. Only thing left to do now is to braze it. Well, guys, I think it's a little black and burnt now, but don't worry about that. I'm going to cool it off, wash it off, run some water through it, dry it off, run some acetone through it, and then next video, we're going to get to work on that Cascade cycle heat pump. So, I'll see you next one.